Welcome to the Cyborg Vlog. It's been 2 years since I had my pacemaker implanted, so let's get caught up on how things are going. That's right, I've had a computer-controlled heart for the last 2 years. So let's do a quick recap. When I was 36, I found out that my heart rate was dropping below 50 beats per minute while I slept, and sometimes it was pausing for up to 6 seconds. So this was concerning for my doctor. So he scheduled me to have a dual chamber MRI safe pacemaker implanted. I've had a few tuning issues with it right at the beginning, but all of those have been worked out now. If you'd like a quick recap of my journey through getting the pacemaker and recovery, I'll put a link to my playlist in the description. For a quick update on my stats, during my last pacemaker interrogation, I was told that I was being paced 11% of the time while I slept, and that I still had 10 years of my battery remaining. If you've been following along, you'll know that at first I was doing a lot of thinking and worrying about getting the pacemaker. I was concerned that I was defective, my life was going to be shortened, and I was scared. So that kind of gave me a sense of urgency to get things done. I don't want to call it like a midlife crisis, but it made me rethink the things that were important and reprioritize the things I wanted to do with my life. I started living more in the present. I still plan and save for the future, but I reprioritize things that I want to get done now. For example, I started making time to do things that I always wanted to but never got around to. One of those things was creating a journal, and this is more for the family to look back on in a few years. It's recording family events and activities that may otherwise fade from memory as the years go on, but I wanted to record those so we could have those memories in the future and look back. Another thing I wanted to do was make more time to read. I had been collecting these books over the years that interested me, that I always wanted to read, but never seemed to find the time to go ahead and do that. So now each week I set aside some time and make sure, you know, I get a nice cup of coffee and sit down in a quiet room and take the time to actually read and enjoy the books that I've always wanted to. Another thing I did was I started planning more family vacations that were experiences. There were things that I'd always wanted to do, like go to Yellowstone or the Grand Canyon or something like that, but I never prioritized them because my daughter was young and I wanted to do these activities, you know, when she quote unquote would still be able to remember them when she's older. But I came to find out that there is some value in taking kids. They do enjoy in the moment, even if, you know, when they grow up, the memories are distant. You know, we still have the journal and pictures to look back on. And I also had her create a scrapbook and her own journal that she could write down her experiences when we're taking these family vacations. Part of what changed my mind was that sense of urgency I said from before. You know, while that's kind of faded away as the years have gone on, you know, I still wanted to prioritize and do things in the now a little bit more and realize that there's value in doing these things now. And in the future, if it's a good vacation, we had a good experience at Yellowstone and my daughter enjoyed it, you know, that may be something we could revisit again when she's a little bit older as well. So besides the Yellowstone trip, which was a lot of fun for our family, and I also made a couple of videos if you want to check those out. I would suggest anybody go if you have an interest and you're able to. Some other things we did as a family is like go out to Disneyland. That's one of our favorite vacation spots. And I did some fun things with my daughter, like build a lightsaber. That's something we probably normally wouldn't have done. It seemed like a big expense, but it was a fun thing. And she's really getting into Star Wars now. She likes Rey, and I think it was a fun experience for both of us. You know, maybe a little bit more for me, but it was fun. So over the last 2 years, having a pacemaker has really become a normal part of my life. I'm no longer worried about getting in situations where I'm concerned about the pacemaker, like going through airport security or being out in public and having run into electromagnets that are going to affect it. I really don't have that worry anymore. At first, there was a fear I had of getting the pacemaker. It made me feel like my heart was defective and that I was broken because I needed this. But that attitude's kind of changed over the last 2 years to where now I see it as something that's making me complete, that's helping me. And my life would be worse off without it than having it. And I feel privileged to live in a time where medical science has been able to develop something that keeps my heart beating or helps it when it needs the help. Well, let me know what you think. Do you have a pacemaker or do you know somebody that does? Leave some comments on this video and let me know how your life has changed, how long you've had the pacemaker, and if it's, changed your life in any way. I'm interested to hear back from you. And if you like the content of the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for future videos. And as always, thank you for watching.
Subscribe now. Resistance is futile.